Hey guys, welcome to Mortal Monster Wrestling and welcome to my 205 Live and NXT review. So, first off, we'll start with 205 Live. So, 205 Live was mostly based on one match. There were two matches. Let's start with the first match. Gentleman Jack Gallagher and Brian Kendrick versus the Luchador House Parties, Lince Dorado and Kalisto. So that was a good match, as most of the 205 Live matches are. Kendrick and Gallagher were amazing, because they are amazing. Gallagher is one of the top talents in 205 Live, Lince Dorado, he got a very good hot tag. Gallagher and Kendrick worked on Kalisto, and then Lince Dorado got the hot tag, and he did some very good flips and stuff. And Gulak was on the commentary, was like, no fly zone and stuff. It was a great, good match, but yeah, it was boring. I was excited for the Murphy versus Alexander match, so I didn't care about this match as much. Then we had the second match of the night. Buddy Murphy versus Cedric Alexander had a great build in terms of kayfabe too. Alexander is like the chosen one of 205 Live, as he was the soul in the WrestleMania match against Mustafa Ali. He was the soul of 205 Live. Yeah, he said he's been carrying this division, though Neville carried it. And he was also put over by Triple H in his match against Kota Ibushi, when Ibushi beat him, but then the crowd was cheering for Cedric, and Cedric was drinking those cheers and taking it. Triple H came down to the ramp and raised his hand, putting him over, that you should look after this guy. This guy is amazing. And yeah, so the match was disappointing. Yeah, the match was disappointing, but the match was great. But it was disappointing because I thought it should have been the greatest 205 Live match ever and should be match of the year contender. But that match was one of the best matches of 205 Live, not the best, because you look at the talent like Cedric Alexander and Buddy Murphy, you look, oh my god, these talents are amazing. So yeah, in kayfabe terms, Alexander was the chosen one, and Murphy was like the guy who just won the tag titles in NXT and then he did nothing. He had so much talent, he's like one of the best wrestlers in the world right now. And yeah, I'm also watching the Best of Super Juniors, but no, Murphy is just great. His performance in the 205 Live tournament against Ali was great, against Daivari, I don't know what his name is. His matches against Mustafa Ali, his fatal 4-way match for the number one contendership, all were great. Buddy Murphy is just great. His athleticism, his selling is great. The match itself was, was great. It had some great technical wrestling, great high-flying stuff, great selling by Murphy and other stuff. The only problem with this match was Murphy didn't get that much offense. I wish Murphy would get more offense than this. But yeah, I think Murphy will take the title later in the line. So yeah, some of the good spots in the match were Alexander hitting a top con hilo on Murphy, and also hitting a, Cedric hit a flatliner on Murphy on the apron. Other great spots were Murphy hit a somersault plancha on Cedric outside, just hitting the table. See, the difference between top con hilo and somersault plancha is that in somersault plancha you touch the ropes, the person gets lifted through a rope and then hits some somersault on the other person on the outside, while in top con hilo they don't use the ropes, they just go by the power of their legs and the body just throw themselves on the other guy on the outside. Cedric also hit a tope suicida, and Cedric also hit a super kick. Cedric hit a Michinoku driver, and yeah, Cedric hit and Cedric also hit those springboard kicks he hits to his opponents, two of them, and then hit a lumbar check. Murphy's offense was like a running suplex, a calf kick on an airborne Alexander, and he just snatched his leg on Alexander when Alexander was on the announce table. And he also hit, he hits the knees. Murphy's knees are amazing, his strikes are amazing. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Murphy didn't get that much offense. Most of the match was in Alexander's hand. So yeah, but the match was great. So yeah, guys, now I want Ali versus Alexander versus Murphy at Money in the Bank, and I hope Murphy wins the championship this time. I can wish. But yeah, that was my 2-5 live review. Thank you. Hey guys, so this is my NXT review. NXT was a great show. It had 6 segments. It was a very informative show. It was a must-see show and can't-miss show. It had like, it had everything from it build towards the matches, build up for possible feuds. And some matches were created in this episode. So yeah, let's start. At first they showed the recap of the last NXT episode where Johnny Gargano called Ciampa, and Ciampa hit him, and Johnny fell on Candice. Then this show started with Aleister Black coming out in his in-ring gear. I thought he would have a match, but no. He came out to cut a promo, because when he comes to cut a promo, he's always in his black gothic suit. So yeah, he stated that he's feeling very good after becoming NXT champion, and the NXT championship win has changed his life, and he should not speak like that. I personally think so, because he's a gothic badass motherfucker. He shouldn't speak like that. He should be like, I'm gonna kick your ass, I'm gonna chop your head off. But yeah, he said one thing which was good, which was like, I only need one shot to defeat my opponents, to kill someone, which made Lars Sullivan come out, his opponent for NXT TakeOver Chicago. And Lars cut a promo that I'm a big man, I'm muscle head, and I'm gonna kick your ass and stuff. Then Black tried to hit a black mask on him. Sullivan caught it, and then he hit a freak accident on him. Freak accident is a bad finisher. I personally don't like it. It's just lifting his opponent and slamming him down, which isn't good, in my opinion. Then we had the second segment, which was NXT was show. Whoa, EC3. Oh my God. EC3 was shown outside in his suit coming to the arena, and then his theme song hit, and he came out having he had a match with Fabian Aichner. Aichner was in control in the match in the beginning. Then he tried to do a move. He tried to do a springboard move. EC3 pushed his leg and he fell outside. That's when Johnny Gargano came out and said that the stipulation for his versus Ciampa match at NXT TakeOver Chicago is Chicago Street Fight, which he came between the match of EC3 and Aichner, which is foreshadowing the possible future feud between EC3 and Gargano. EC3 may cost him the match at Chicago, TakeOver Chicago. So then the match continued where Aichner hit an amazing top turnbuckle crossbody to the outside, which was just great. He did it amazingly. Then EC3 came in control again. He hit a reverse STO on Eckner and then hit a fisherman carry neck breaker or fisherman carry cutter on Eckner and then pinned him. Then we have the next segment of they had the interviews with Bianca Belair. That was good. Then we had a squash match between War Raiders and the other two local jobbers. War Raiders killed them. You know, War Raiders are amazing. War Machine is amazing. Hansen is amazing. Hansen is the better one, I think. Yeah, but both of them are actually very good. They killed the jobbers. Ricochet beat Dijak then. It was a great match. Ricochet won by a 360 splash on Donovan Dijak. Dijak also hit some moves, had some offense. He hit a apron choke slam on Ricochet when Ricochet tried to hit him with Dijak also hit him with a springboard drop kick. So yeah, when the match was over, Ricochet cut a promo on Velveteen that Velveteen attacked him last week and called Velveteen a punk. Velveteen came out and he said that everything that Ricochet can do, he can do better. Then Ricochet just did an amazing thing. It was one of the best things I've ever seen. He did a topic on Hilo and landed on his feet and just said in Van Velveteen's mic that then do this, which was great. Then we had a final match for the NXT Women's Championship between Dakota Kai and the champion Shayna Baszler. It was a pretty good match. Baszler was on Dakota's leg instead of her arm and did the same spot with the leg of Dakota, which she did with Ember's hand. She worked on the leg of Dakota Kai. Dakota's selling was great. Then Dakota has a comeback, which was pretty good. But Baszler won with a chokehold. And then went to beat Dakota again. Then Nikki Cross came out. Baszler went out. But Cross just went after her and took her title. Then she gave Dakota the title. Dakota her title. So that she can ref the match between Baszler and her. And Baszler was like, what the fuck is happening? She went to Dakota and said, and was like, give me the title, you 13-year-old bitch. And then Nikki Cross just hit her finisher on Baszler. Dakota counted 2-3. And Nikki Cross just stole the title and went away. So this was my NXT review. Thank you guys. Please like, share and subscribe if you like it. Thank you and have a nice day.